Lord Jesus. Kalabashataba. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, glory be to your name, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, we give you praise. 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 You're faithful. Amen. In Jesus' name, we're prayed. Amen. All right, we're going to be praying this morning, but before then, there was a song that's just been on my heart for a bit now. Blessings and honor, glory and power be unto the Ancient of Days. From every nation, all of creation, bow before the Ancient of Days. Oh, every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you will be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. Kalaboshalia. Your kingdom shall reign over the earth. Sing to the Ancient of Days, for none can compare to your matchless love. Sing to the Ancient of Days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you will be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. O Kalabashataba, O Ancient of Days. The first scripture we're going to pray from is when you wake up with a song, or the Lord nudges, put a song in your spirit, you just have to learn to go after that word. Amen. Just have to learn to go after the word. You know, just have to go. Hallelujah. I'm going to read the book of Jude. Hallelujah. Jude 1, 26. But you, my delightful loved friends, constantly and progressively build up yourself on the foundation of your most holy faith. I want to use other translations so we'll pray this morning. Jude chapter 1. Your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. Sing to the Ancient of Days. For none can compare to your matchless word. Sing to the Ancient of Days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. In worship you will be exalted, O God, and your kingdom shall not pass away, O Ancient of Days. Hallelujah. Jude 1:20. I'm using different translations. It says, but you, beloved, building yourself on your most holy faith by praying in the Holy Ghost. But you, dear friend, must build each other up in your most holy faith, praying in the power of the Holy Ghost. Anybody excited about the Holy Ghost? We do not have a high priest that is not in touch with our infirmity. Glory to God. Say, but you, beloved, build yourself up, founded on your most holy faith. Make progress like an edifice, halabo shata, higher and higher, praying in the Holy Spirit. I love the Amplified Version. It says, but you, beloved, build yourself up, founded on your most holy faith, making progress, rise like an edifice, higher and higher, praying in the Holy Ghost. I know some people have said, it's not compulsory to pray with the Holy Ghost. If you read through scripture in the book of Acts, every time they gave their life to Christ, every time there was a ministration, the next thing it is, you see them praying for them, receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. The first time we saw the outpouring of the Holy Ghost, the infilling of the Holy Ghost in Acts chapter 2, one of the things that followed was there was declaration in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. There was prayer in the Holy Ghost. And that is what we are contending this morning. That's what we're praying for this morning. That Lord, we are, sorry, hold a minute. I need to remove all the sound on my desktop. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. That we are contending, we're praying. I don't know who you are. I don't know where you are. I don't know what it is. Build up your most holy faith by praying in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. By praying in the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praying, you encourage yourself by praying in the Holy Ghost. You build yourself up by praying in the Holy Ghost. You stay on the word by praying. You pray in the Holy Ghost. So that said, as you grow higher. So you grow higher and higher like an edifice as you pray in the Holy Ghost. But you, dear friend, carefully build yourself up in this most holy faith. By praying the Holy Ghost, staying right at the center of God's love, keeping your arms open, outstretched, ready for the mercy of our Father, Jesus Christ. This is an unending life, the real life. This is the real life, the life where you pray in the Holy Ghost, where you stretch your hands out, ready to receive from the Father. Hallelujah. For you, my friend, I believe the message that comes from God himself. So you must help one another to trust God more and more. Pray to God with the help of the Holy Ghost. So one of the ways why we pray together in the Holy Ghost is that, you know what? You are helping yourself more and more. We are helping, you know, one another. We are building one another. So, but ye beloved, build yourself up in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Anybody ready to pray in the Holy Ghost this morning? Anybody ready to build edifice? How high is your edifice? You know, the beautiful thing about this is that you can go as high as you want by intending, by contending. You know, another reason why I love to pray in the Holy Spirit this morning, which is what I'm talking about, the reason why I love to pray in the Holy Spirit, the Bible says in the book of Romans 8, that we do not know what to pray as we ought to, but the Spirit of God maketh intercessions in groanings that cannot be uttered. It prays for us. Another scripture, if you see in the book of John chapter 17, it says that the Lord, the Holy Ghost is interceding. The Spirit of God was, Jesus was interceding for us. He said we have an high priest interceding for us. In the book of John chapter 14 and 16, you see, when the Amplified Version talks about the Holy Ghost, he says our intercessor, our sure guard, our helper, our standby. I remember a time when I was teaching on the call and teaching us about the Holy Ghost, our sure guard, our intercessor, our standby, our God, our... See, sometimes when I don't know what to do, I pray in the Holy Ghost. And the word of God begins to come alive. Come on. The Bible says that the Spirit of the Lord will remind you and remind you of all that God has said to us. Are there things God has said to us during Rafael? Are there things God has said to you in time past? Are there things God has said to us in this month? Our month of coming alive. Hallelujah. Our month of coming alive. Our month where we saw in Ezekiel chapter 37, you know, the word of the Lord to us. He said to the dry bone, can this dry bone live again? I said, thou knowest, to God. Thou knowest. And they begin to give us the word, prophesy, say to this. And we saw the bone come together and the breath was missing. And then we declare, what am I saying that? The Spirit of the Lord brings to remembrance. There's some things you've forgotten. There's some dreams. There's some interpretation. There are some things you have forgotten. And the Holy Ghost begins to bring it up to your remembrance. Hallelujah. He said, build up your most holy faith by praying the Holy Ghost. He said, you are building up edifice when you pray in the Holy Ghost. You go higher and higher and higher when you pray in the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. You grow higher and higher. In heaven, what is the atmosphere? What is the atmosphere of heaven? Is the atmosphere of joy, is the atmosphere of peace, is the atmosphere of worship, is the atmosphere of the glory of God. Hallelujah. And yesterday we're talking about the goodness of God. So I'm telling you why you should pray in the Holy Ghost. You know, there's speaking in tongues, there's praying in tongues, there's the interpretation of tongues. As we begin to pray in the Holy Ghost, sometimes, I don't know if it happens to you, as you're praying in the Holy Ghost, you begin to feel like you understand what you're saying. It's almost like you are interacting with something. You are declaring something. You are interacting with something. You know, you are praying in the Holy Ghost. You're praying in the Holy Ghost. You're praying in the Holy Ghost. And that's what we're going to be doing. We are praying in the Holy Ghost. We are building up our most holy faith. You are declaring. Sometimes you're speaking English over the Lord. You know, you switch it up. And at times when you're praying in the Spirit, what happened is you begin to even have the scriptures to use to contend. At that moment, the Lord begins to bring to remembrance scripture. The Lord, some of us that have dreams, the Lord begins to bring interpretation into your spirit. Come on. The Lord begins to speak into our spirit, man. We begin to contend. We begin to, you know, so I tell people, even when I'm in tears, I just need to get in the presence, my God. I just need to be in that place. I just need to worship. I just need to pray. Even as I'm having questions arise, I begin to, as I pray in the Holy Ghost, I begin to receive answers. I begin to receive strengthening. I begin to receive courage. I begin to see scriptures come alive, and the Lord begins to highlight scripture. You are building edifice. The Bible says that if your strength is weak in the days of adversity, so if you faint in the days of adversity, then your strength is weak. And guess what? The strength, the joy of the Lord, glory to God, is our strength. He said, with joy we will draw from the wells of foundation. Yesterday, we were talking about the goodness of God. And I know that God is so intentional because the character of God is unshakable. I love the way Emmanuel said it. God did not become good. No, God did not become merciful because of Abraham and Adam and Eve sinned. God did not say, wow, I need to develop mercy now. Wow, they've sinned. How am I going to deal with their sin now? I need mercy. God could show mercy to Adam and Eve because he was merciful. God could show goodness to you because he is a good God. He is good not because he does good. Good things emanate from him because he is good. And sometimes when you are pressed on all sides, you need to, you know, yesterday I was telling us that it's not funny that Paul that was in chains was the one telling those of us that were walking on the street that rejoice, and I say again, rejoice. He was bound, but he said rejoice. But there's something about the Holy Ghost. There's something about the infilling of the Holy Ghost on your inside that begins to bring things alive. Oh, Pia, he's saying that there are times when you're not there. Oh, my God. Oh, you know, yesterday morning, as we're done praying, you know, I just had a moment in the morning. My yesterday was just like, whoa. And one of the things that was that, you know what, as we you behold in his face, you're having conversations with God. Tell God how you feel. All right, we're not saying it. Faith is not negating what how you feel. Fact, okay, Lord, this is fact, but this is what your word says. This is how I'm feeling. God, what are we doing right here? And you pray in the Holy Ghost. I tell people till I perceive, I travel. You're in the place of traveling, praying the Holy Ghost till you perceive directly. So sometimes things happen to people. It can't take us away from the presence. It's only people that don't understand the way the kingdom works. You need to remain there. I love the way Mazuma says it. He said, when things start to happen to us, and the devil has a way of lying, you know, when the devil starts to sell lie to you, the moment you begin to eat the lie, he's taking you on a journey. He's going to take you down on a journey and begin to tell you things. And then your head will not want to, no. We stay praying. We stay in the Holy Ghost. We stay in the Holy Ghost. We stay in the Holy Ghost, full of joy, full of glory. Hallelujah. Full of glory, full of joy. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. So we're saying, your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. That's the song I was singing this morning. Sing to the ancient of days, for none can compare to your matchless love. Sing to the ancient of days. Every tongue in heaven and earth shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow at your throne. Ha! In worship, you will be exalted, O God. Ha, ya, ya, ya. And your kingdom shall not pass away, O ancient of days. Ha, ya, 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 ya. Oh, makalabasukata. If where you are is not noisy, I want you to unmute your mic. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know what you're facing, but I want to build some edifice in the spirit. And the Bible says the way we build edifice in the spirit, we'll pray in the Holy Ghost.
We have
come to Mount Zion, the city of the living God. I'm going to go to the hospital.
I got to live up on the Ora, We give you praise. Come on, begin to give God praise. When you cast down your build up, when you tear down your build up, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise. Jesus, we give you praise. Jesus, we give you praise. I never see this kind of God before. We never see this kind of God before.
Wonder, Jesus, my love.
love you are light. You make everything alright.
We bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. For those of us that still struggle to pray extensively, I'm telling you, pray in the Holy Ghost and try to focus when you're doing it. Try, ask the Lord for grace when you want to engage praying in the Spirit, and ask the Lord to give you strength. And as you pray, whatever comes to your spirit, write it out. Whatever comes to your mind, write it out. Whatever the Lord drops in your spirit, write it out. As we pray, what songs come to your mind, what scripture, as we pray right now, Psalms 33 rose up in me. And I realized, wow, thank you, Jesus. That's your word. You pray till you have a note of victory. A note of victory can be a song. It can be a scripture. It can be an interpretation. It can be peace. It can be laughter. It can be joy. You pray till you know. You contend. You pray in the name of Jesus. And we declare that God is good. Amen. Don't forget your progress report. Don't forget to keep writing. Don't forget to keep declaring your progress report in the name of Jesus. The Lord God will strengthen us all in Jesus' name. Amen. The other prayer watches by 9, by 12, by 3, by 6. 9 p.m. we'll study the word again. 12 midnight we'll pray. 3 a.m. we'll pray. 6 a.m. and we're praying throughout. We're praying the scripture, Jude chapter 20. And the Lord will give us grace in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. I look forward to seeing you again. Be strengthened and be encouraged. Have a blessed day. And I look forward to your testimonies. Remember, you build up your most holy faith by praying. Build up edifice as you are going. Don't waste traffic. Don't waste any moment. Build up your most holy faith in the name of Jesus. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow. Hallelujah.